You think that everybody else, the rest of the markets around the globe, are on sale by comparison. Is that where you're telling people to put their money right now?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like a kid in a candy store right now, and no, you might feel the same way. I mean, things just sold off so grossly in December that you just have to look at the global markets, and you know, if you look at valuations overseas, they're even cheaper than the U.S. right now. You're getting dividend yields of over 4%, and then you look at growth rates around the world at maybe close to 3% this year. I think you just have to think globally right now when you're putting money to work in your portfolio. You can't just be U.S.-centric.
Do you agree with that or not, Noah?
I don't know. I mean, if you look around the globe, I'd say that we've been big investors in China for a long period of time. A lot of people, I think, attribute the weakness in China to the trade and tariff war. Mm-hmm. That's somewhat true. But they're missing a whole piece of the China story, which was the regulatory environment last year, whether it was on video games or after-school education or healthcare. The regulations, every day I walked into the office, there's more regulations of industry in China like I've never really seen before in all my years of investing there. So the government really cracked down on business very hard at the same time they're in a trade war. And then I look at Europe, I mean, you know, fiscal policy doesn't work. I mean, you need tax incentives in Europe. You need capital formation. I mean, you've brought in 1 million workers and economy is growing less than 2%. You need the tax incentives, and I don't really see any sort of regulatory relief or incentives in Europe right now. I mean, sure, there are one-off or two-off companies, but we need to move away from monetary policy and maybe get some fiscal stimulus, certainly in Europe. China has starting, that's for sure.
I think you'd be right about that, but I mean, to some extent, let's face it, a lot of that's got to be priced in at this point. I mean, you know, you're looking at emerging markets specifically, they're trading out like a 27% discount to the rest of the world, which is cheaper than normally is. I have to think at this point, there's got to be some value there because, no, you know that, I know that, the rest of the world knows that.
I mean, China's about 40% of the emerging markets index, and if the stimulus goes through and if the regulatory regime is paused, then, yeah, the EM could work well. If the Fed is paused and they get some dollar relief, that could drive that too. But what's the case for Europe?
I know you have record unemployment, you know, for it's the lowest in 10 years. And again, I just think looking at valuations overseas, I mean, with GDP has grown at, what, 22 quarters in a row. I mean, it's not all bad, and I think the headline risk right now is probably weighing on prices more than the actual economies overseas.